sisters gathered on October 6th in Martin DePora's room for 3 o'clock lunch, at Mariu's invitation, one could not anticipate that DSI, Dominican Sisters International, would become more than an acronym for another Dominican collaboration. We clearly experienced in the persons of Sister Maria Fabiola, Rosemary Riley, and Tony Harris that we are Dominican Sisters International. As members of the Order of Preachers, we have sisters around the globe, not only in theory, but in relationship. Sister Maria Fabiola no sooner walked in the room when she started going to each sister, introducing herself and finding out something not about us, but about her sisters. In her greeting and ours, we became more deeply sisters to each other. That is Dominican Sisters International. Mary Hughes reminded us, we say where one of us is, we all are. Dominican Sisters International mean we span the globe in our outreach. Sister Maria Fabiola is the international coordinator of DSI. She comes from Colombia. She told us with a quick wit that having served her congregation with thousands of sisters in many countries for two terms as general superior, she had thought she was finished with meetings and scheduling. When she was called forth to be the new international coordinator of DSI 3 years ago. She said it's been a wonderful, intensive experience of the Dominican Order. Sister Rosemary Riley is the prioress of the Springfield Dominicans and was recently elected coordinator of the North American region. Sister Tony Harris is the international co-promoter for justice and peace. She works in Rome at Santa Sabina with Sister Fabiola and often travels with her. Sister Maria Fabiola said it at this moment, we are called to preach hope. Since she began this ministry, she has visited 28 countries. As she began to explain to us, in DSI, we are 154 congregations in 113 countries with about 25,500 sisters throughout the world. We are divided into regions, the Asia Pacific, which goes from the Pacific Ocean to Israel and down to Australia, Europa, Africa, North America, and Latin America. We are sisters united by the charism of preaching. Recently, Sister Fabiola was invited to be part of the general chapter of the men of the Order of Preachers. She gave witness to the fact that the sisters in the order, at this moment, we know we have the same charism. We are called to preach. Our attitude, our lives, everything we do preaches. Who we are as individuals is important to all of us, because each of us is a preaching. We must preach the gospel. We must bring hope, esperanza. Sister Fabiola told several stories of how she experienced sisters bringing hope. A watery rice porridge, when possible, is fed by our sisters to children in a poor school in Timor. It frees the parents, and when asked why, it's because those 3 days a week they can feed their other children because those in school are fed that one bowl of porridge. That is their meal for the day. Millions of people live like that. But that bowl of porridge brings hope. In Vietnam, there was a congregation Sister Fabiola visited, and as she arrived late, she came into a room full of white veils. This congregation had over 100 novices. She questioned them as to their motivation. Was it food or housing or what? One sister told her there were 4 cardiologists, a number of social workers and healthcare professionals, and other professionals. She was 32, and in that culture they were old with no future. But more importantly, her family had been Christian. and her brother and father were killed in North Vietnam for that very reason. She came because she believed, and is a result of the blood of martyrs. Another congregation in Bruges, Belgium, has only 22 members who range in age from 76 to 94. They had a new way of finding a family. They gave DSI a gift of many euros with the one stipulation that it was to be used for the formation of our Dominican sisters throughout the world. There are few vocations in Europe, and they felt in this way, when their congregation dies, their preaching continues in the Sisters of Africa, Asia, and Latin America, who benefit from special programs to help them grow in Dominican spirituality and Dominican life. Fabiola has visited them and given them reports, and that brings sisters such hope. Sister Toni Harris spoke of her role as promoter of peace and justice. She told of a place in Indonesia where there was a conference on work. That nation cannot support all its citizens, so many go to foreign places to work. There is one terminal in the airport dedicated simply to those comings and goings. However, when many of those workers returned, they have been treated as slaves, abused, and some are so disoriented they don't know their names. Some have been fed a bowl of rice a day from working from dawn till midnight, others sexually or psychologically abused. The government tries to at least minimally address the problem with a facility that deals with those people. Sister Rosemary Riley spoke of how she is learning about DSI from each of the gatherings she has had in meeting sisters from different places and hearing the stories that widen her understanding of the order. She spoke in particular of the DSI assembly this spring, where many places where our sisters minister at risk of their very lives shared their situations. Pakistan, Iraq, Africa, and more. But then some from these very countries asked, how could they support the sisters in the United States in this apostolic visitation? Sister Rosemary spoke of how that question touched her deeply. Sister Fabiola said that, at this moment, we must preach. We are doing it in very many ways throughout the world. Some places have young vocations. How do we assist them in formation? How do we connect with projects around the globe? As Sister Mary Hughes explained, our Amityville Dominican congregation supports DSI in the work of Sister Kathleen McGinn, who does the finances and investments for DSI, as Sister Barbara Sussman had done before her. She coordinates some of this with Toni Harris in Rome. Dominican Sisters International has many faces, and now we have a sense of that, thanks to Mary, Fabiola, Toni, and Rosemary. And the preaching continues.